So now let's do exercise number 1. Find the mistakes in the given sentences. Dear students, on the behalf of this understanding, we need to do this exercise. Let's do. So our first sentence is, where do you live? Where do you live? So please tell me, dear students, raise your hand if you know that there is a one mistake in this sentence. Where do you live? Can you tell me which is the mistake? Yes, Manika is there. She will let us know. Manika, please tell me which is the mistake. Where do you live in this sentence? One mistake is there. Please tell me which is the mistake.
But there is not interrogative mark.
Yes, very good. In the last, we need to mention. So our sentence is the where do you live? So that's the interrogative sentence. So like question mark, we need to mention there. So question mark will come. Very good. Your answer is absolutely right. So we need to write here. Answer, where do you live? Right? So always remember, whenever we write any sentence, first letter is capital. And in the last, we need to write like either like full stop or question mark. Or we can write also like exclamation mark according to the syntax. Next sentence, we live in Karnal. We live in Karnal. So please raise your hand if you can tell me what is the mistake in this sentence. We live in Karnal. Ekansh, please you tell me. Ekansh, yes, please. What is the mistake in this sentence?
Sir, bada capital aayega aur Karnal ke baad full stop aayega.
Okay, yes. One mistake is also there. Ekansh, there are two mistakes in this sentence. Two mistakes are there. Please identify the second mistake.
Sir, W and Karnal is capital.
Yes, W will be capital because that's the initial word. And secondly, Karnal is proper name. So whenever we talk about, yes, very good. Ekansh, your answer is absolutely right. So K we need to write in capital form, and also a W means V word means W we need to write in capital, right? So let's see the answer. We live in Karnal. Very good. Next sentence. Shall I start the class? Shall I start the class? So who can give me the answer? Raise your hand. Shall I start the class? What are the mistakes in this sentence? Sandhya is here. Sandhya, please tell me. What are the mistakes in this sentence?
Sir, shall mein S bada aega.
Yes, S will be capital. I capital and
last mein question mark aayega.
Last mein question mark aayega. Yes, very good. Right answer. Sandhya, you have given the right answer. Very good. Let's see the answer. Shall I start the class? Means S will be capital. I will be capital in the last. Question mark will be there. So dear students, whenever we write I, individual I letter we write in a sentence to represent means myself. That case, we need to write I always in capital form. So we need to write here, shall I start the class? Next, how beautiful this city is. How beautiful this city is. So what can be the answer of this sentence? Natik, please you tell me. Natik, how beautiful this city is. What can be the answer?
Exclamatory mark.
Yes, exclamatory mark will be there because that's a exclamatory sentence, right? Good. Good, Natik, you have given the right answer. So let's see that. How beautiful this city is, right? Come on, the next sentence. How are you? What are the mistakes in this sentence? Prince will let me know. Prince, yes, you please tell me. How are you?
Sir, question mark aayega.
Question mark.
Sir,
and second,
H
will be capital. And secondly, question mark will be there. It is good. You have given the right answer. How are you? Need to write in this way. Come on, the second, like the next sentence. Please close the door. Please close the door. Who can give me the answer? Raise your hand, please. Who can give me the answer? Rachit is there. Rachit, नो नो रचित इज नॉट, संध्या नैतिक एकांश मानिका लेट मी सी न्यू स्टूडेंट्स प्रिंस ओके एकांश यू प्लीज टेल मी एकांश यू टेल मी व्हाट इज द आंसर प्लीज क्लोज द डोर
सर सर पी इज कैपिटल सर पी कैपिटल
पी इज कैपिटल एंड वन मोर मिस्टेक इज देयर
सर डोर के बाद फुल स्टॉप आएगा इन
द फुल स्टॉप विल बी देयर बिकॉज़ दैट इज इंपेरेटिव सेंटेंस
इंपेरेटिव सेंटेंस
यस वी नीड टू मेंशन फुल स्टॉप यस वेरी गुड यू हैव गिवन द राइट आंसर प्लीज क्लोज द डोर वी नीड टू राइट इन दिस वे सो sentence we have understood now we let's talk about the phrase so what are the phrase right a group of words that make sense but not complete sense is called a phrase so dear students whenever we use a group of words if that group of words makes sense that is a sentence if that is makes a half sense means we can say incomplete sense that is called a phrase let's understand this point with some examples like if someone asks you like in which school do you study in which school do you study and you give the answer I study in the Century School I study in the Century School that is a sentence right because these are the words and these words are giving a complete meaning or complete sense so that's why it is a sentence so if you say that in the Century School that is phrase try to understand if someone asks you in which school do you study and if you say that I study in the Century School so that is a sentence but if you say in short with the few words you try to give the answer in the Century School so these words also give some sense but not complete sense so that's why these words are called phrase Where were you yesterday? Someone asks you, where were you yesterday? कोई तुमसे पूछता है कि कल तुम कहाँ थे? So if you say that I was in the park and you were in the park and you say that I was in the park, so that is the sentence. But instead of saying I was in the park, you simply say that with some words you use that in the park, right? Someone asks you where were you yesterday, you say in the park. So these words in the park are a phrase, right? So I think you must have understood what are the phrases and what are the sentences. Now make some sentences using the flowing phrases. So dear students, some phrases I'm just going to write here. You need to make some sentences with these phrases. आपको इन phrases की help से कुछ sentence बनाने हैं. First one or two I will let you know, and then rest you should try. Suppose our phrases that are good fielding, are good fielding. So we can say our sentence: We will win the match because of our good fielding. We will win the match because of our good fielding, right? Or we can say our good fielding will help us to win the match. So whatever we want to say, we can say that. Ultimately, we have to use these phrases, right? Come on, the next phrases for playing cricket. For playing cricket, who can make a sentence? Who can make a sentence with this phrase? Please raise your hand. Ekansh, can you make? Make a sentence with the help of for playing cricket.
Sir, I am going to the park for playing cricket.
I am going to park for playing cricket. Yes, very
playing cricket.
Very good, Ekansh. The right answer. Or we can also say that we went there for playing cricket, right? Or I can also say that I will get up early for playing cricket, right? Next phrase: behind the school building. Behind the school building. What sentence can you make? Yug Chaudhary. Yes, Yug, please give me answer. What can you make? What sentence can you make behind the school building?
Sir, there is a park.
There is a park.
Sir, there is a park behind the school building.
There is a park behind the school building. Very good. Good answer.
Behind the school building.
Behind the school building. Yes, we can make sentence in this way. So we can also write the answer. There were some factories behind the school building, or we can also say his house is just behind the school building. Okay, our next sentence is almost next phrase is that almost impossible. Almost impossible. Try to make some sentences with the help of almost impossible. Who can make, please raise your hand. Netik, you please come. Netik, please, yes. Unmute yourself and tell me, almost impossible. Make some sentence. Netik, can you make? Okay, Rupal, you please come and make a sentence with the help of almost impossible phrase.
This pipe is almost impossible to fix.
This pipe is almost impossible to fix. Very good. Good answer. Or even we can write here, that work was almost impossible, right? It is almost impossible to go on the moon. So whatever you want to say, you can say that with the help of these phrases. Come on the next part. So let's talk about types of sentences, right? So dear students, we know that kinds of sentences means type of sentences. Four types of sentences are there: declarative, interrogative, imperative, and exclamatory. Declarative, interrogative, imperative, and exclamatory. So let's understand all the things. Declarative sentence. Declarative sentences state something. So in which sentence we state something, that is called declarative sentence. Example, you are my friend. So in this, I'm declaring something. I'm saying that you are my friend. So that is declarative sentence. Or if I say that you don't come late, so I'm stating something. I'm just telling something. So that is declarative sentence. Now further, declarative sentence is divided into two parts. First is called positive, second is called negative. Positive means he is a tall boy. In this, I haven't used not or never. Means I haven't used negative sentence in this. And negative is this, that in which we use not, like he is not a tall boy, right? If I say you are my students, so that is positive sentence. But if I say you are not my students, so that is negative sentence. But these all the sentences means you are my students and you are not my students. These all the sentences are declarative sentences. Next, interrogative or interrogative sentences. In interrogative sentence, we ask questions, right? Like, how are you? I'm just asking question. I'm putting a question. Will you go there? Right? So these sentences are called interrogative sentences. Next, imperative. Imperative sentences express command, request, or advice, right? Like examples means open the door. I'm just saying to someone to do that. That work is to open the door, switch on the TV, come here, don't park your car here, never come late, right? So these all the examples of imperative sentences means in which sentence we say to listener to do something. So those sentences are called imperative sentences, right? Fourth number, exclamatory sentences. Exclamatory sentences express some strong feelings, right? What a beautiful car. How beautiful car, right? What a lovely dress. So dear students, whenever we see something and we state something with some emotions, so those sentences are called exclamatory sentences. Suppose you see a beautiful car, and if you say that it is a very beautiful car, it is a very beautiful car, means you are declaring something, you are stating something, that is declarativeness. But with emotion, you if you say that, what a beautiful car, kitni sundar car, right? So that sentence is called exclamatory sentence. What a beautiful car. Or we can say this sentence in this way also. How beautiful car. What a lovely dress. So in the last, we need to mention exclamation mark, right? So these four types of sentences are there. Declarative, in which we state something. Interrogative, in which we put the question. Imperative, in which we order or command or request. Exclamatory, in which we express our strong feelings, right? Now come on the third exercise. Find the type of the following sentences. So dear students, some sentences are written here. You need to tell me the type of those sentences. Okay. First sentence is that, when do you study? When do you study? So please tell me what is the type of this sentence. Okay. Rachit will let me know. Rachit, please tell me the type of this sentence. Means first sentence. Is that declarative, interrogative, imperative, or exclamatory? Okay, you please tell me. When do you study? If I say this sentence, is that declarative, interrogative, or exclamatory?
Sir, interrogative.
How have you come to know that? How have you come to know that?
Sir, there is a W.
Yeah, WH sir, word is in the starting. And, yeah, and yeah. Secondly, in the last, is a question mark. Yes, very good. Good answer. Mark. Very good. Okay. So that is interrogative sentence. You can see the answer. Next sentence, you always help me. What is the type of this sentence? You always help me. Manika, you please tell me. Manika, you please tell me. What is the type?
Declarative.
Yes, declarative. Very good. Because in this, we are declaring something. You always help me. Right? Yes, right answer. Next, tell me something about yourself. Tell me something about yourself. Muskan, you please tell me. What is the type of this sentence?
Sir, declarative.
Declarative. No, Muskan. Tell me something about yourself. Again, try Muskan, please. Muskan, again, try, please, if you know.
Sir, imperative.
Imperative. Because in this, I'm just saying to someone, I'm saying to listener to do something. Tell me something about yourself. Right? So that is imperative sentence. Next, what a great singer Tansen was. What a great singer Tansen was. What is the type of this sentence? And let me see. Prince is there. Prince, please tell me. What is the type of this sentence? What a great singer Tansen was. Sorry?
Exclamatory.
Exclamatory sentence. Because in this we have shown a strong feeling along with this. You can see in the last exclamation mark is there, right? Very good, right answer. Dear students, after giving the answer, please mute to yourself. Mute to yourself, right? Next, who are you? Who are you? What is the type of this sentence? Rachit is here. Rachit, please tell me. Who are you? If I say, who are you? So what is the type of this sentence?
Interrogative, sir.
Yes, interrogative, because in this we have put a question. Good, very good. Next, you haven't done your work. You haven't done your work. What is the type of this sentence? Who can let me know? Let me see. Mayank is there. Mayank. Let me come down. Okay. Nathik, you please tell me. Nathik, you please tell me. What is the type of the sentence number 6?
Sir, imperative.
Imperative, declared imperative. No, Nathik, yes, that's not right answer.
The declarative.
Just declarative. In this, I'm declaring something. You haven't done your work. Main kuch bata raha hun. Main kuch keh raha hun.
Declarative.
That is declarative sentence. Okay, good. Next.
Sir, kuch ho rahi hai. You work. Kuch aur dikha rahe the. Main pata lag raha lead ma.
Haven't you done your work? Haven't you done your work? What is the type of this sentence? Sentence number 7. You tell me.
Sir, interrogative.
Interrogative, yes. Interrogative sentence, haven't you done your work? Right?
Yes, sir.
Please, after giving your answer, mute to yourself. Okay? Jaise answer de dete uske baad apne aap ko mute kar lo. And please down your hand. Come on, the next part, type of interrogative sentences. So dear students, here we have to understand the types of interrogative sentences, right? Yes or no question, WH question. So there are two types of interrogative sentence. First is yes or no question. Second is WH questions, right? Yes or no question. in which question the answer of a in which question the answer of a question can be in yes or no. Those sentences are called yes or no questions. Like, do you go to school? So we can give the answer of this question, yes, I go to school. Or we can give the answer of this question also, no, I do not go to school. So dear students, simply we have to understand there are two types of interrogative sentences. First is in which sentence we can give the answer either in yes or no, right? So those type of questions are called yes or no question. But second type is there, like we can't give the answer in yes or no, we have to describe the things, right? So first, like some examples are here. Do you go to school? So if someone asks you, do you go to school? So you can give the answer in yes, or you can give the answer in no. Yes, I go to school. Or you can say, no, I don't go to school. Second time, and have you eaten the ice cream? So you can give the answer, yes, I have eaten the ice cream. Or you can also say, no, I haven't eaten the ice cream, right? Second time, WH question, in which sentence we can't answer in yes or no. What is your school name? So if someone asks you, what is your school name? You can't say no, or you can't say yes. You need to describe the things. My school name is Da Century School. So that is second type of question, like a interrogative sentence. What do you eat? So in this, you can't say yes or no. You need to tell the name of whatever you eat. So I eat ice cream, right? List of some important WH words. So in dear students, here are some list of important WH words. So we will understand how to use those WH words. First is who. Second is whom. Third is what. Fourth is whose. Fifth is why. Sixth is where. Seventh is when. Eighth is which. And ninth is how. Right? Let's understand them. Firstly, let's talk about who for asking question about subject of a sentence. So dear students, whenever we ask question, we use who, but basically when we come to know about, we want to come to know about subject. Jab main subject ke bare mein janna ho, puchna ho, so that time we should use who word. Like Narendra Modi runs the Indian government. Narendra Modi runs the Indian government. So dear students, we know that Narendra Modi is subject in this sentence because we are totally talking about Narendra Modi, right? So Narendra Modi runs the Indian government. So if we put any sentence in which we want to know about the subject, right? So then we have to use who. So if someone ask you, like if you want to ask a question, who runs the Indian government? So you can see that I have used here who word. Why? Because I want to know about the subject. So whenever you want to know about the subject, so you should use who word. Right. Next, Rajesh sir teaches us English. Or simply if you say Rajesh sir teaches us. Rajesh sir teaches us. So if I want to know about the subject, we know that Rajesh sir is subject here. So if someone asks you, who teaches you? Who teaches you? So it means you want to come to know about the subject. So that's why you have used here who. So who we use whenever we want to know about the subject. Second, whom, for asking about the indirect object of a sentence. So dear students, whenever we want to know about the indirect object of a sentence, then we have to use whom, right? Suppose I say that I called him. So we know that I is subject, called is verb, him is indirect object. Him is indirect object. So whenever we want to know about indirect object, so then we have to use whom. You can see one example. If I want to know that what is the, like who is the indirect object, then we have to use whom. So I can say, whom did you call? Whom did you call means I want to know about indirect object. Second sentence, see that if I say that Rajesh sir is teaching us, Rajesh sir is teaching us. We know that Rajesh sir subject, is teaching verb, us is indirect object, right? So if you want to know about us, or we can say if you want to know about the indirect object, so we should use whom. So we can put the question with the help of whom. Whom is Rajesh sir teaching? Whom is Rajesh sir teaching, right? Let's talk about what. for asking about the direct object. So whenever we want to know about the direct object, so we should use what? Suppose if I say that I eat ice cream. So I is subject, eat is verb, and ice cream is an object. So whenever we want to know about direct object, right? So we should use what? I eat ice cream. So if you want to know about the direct object, so I will say, what do you eat? So by the what, I want to know about the object, and that is direct object. Second sentence, they have done their work. They have done their work, right? So we know that they subject, have done verb, and their work, that is indirect object. So whenever we want to know about direct object, so we should use what? So we can say, what have you done? What have you done? Next, whose? Whose for asking about the owner of something. Whenever we want to know about the owner, means we want to know who is the owner of something. So we should use whose. Like, if I say, this pen belongs to Arun. This pen belongs to Arun, means Arun is the owner of this pen. So if I want to know about the owner of something, so we should use whose. So we can say that, whose pen is this? Whose pen is this? I can say this sentence in this way also. Whose is this pen? So both the sentences are right. Whenever we want to know about the owner of something, jab main kisi ke malik ke bare mein puchna ho ki wo uska malik kaun hai ya wo cheez kisse belong karti hai, then we have to use whose. Deepak has a bike. So Deepak is the owner of a bike. So if you want to know the owner of a bike or that bike, so we should use whose. We can say that whose bike is this? Whose bike is this? I can also say, whose is this bike? Whose is this bike? Right? For asking about the reason of something. So whenever we come to know about the reason of something, we should use why, right? Like, my father helps everyone because he is a social worker. So in this, we are describing the reason my father helps everyone. Why does he help? So reason is that because he is a social worker. So whenever we want to ask about the reason of something, so we should use why. Why does your father help everyone? We attend online classes because we can't go to school. We attend online classes because we can't go to school. So we know that what is the reason of attending the online classes? Because we can't go to school. So if you want to know about the reason of something, so we should use why. Why do you attend the online classes, right? So by this, I want to know the reason of attending the online classes. Where? For asking about the place. So whenever we want to know about the place, we should use where. Like, I live in India. I live in India. So if you want to know about the place, I can put the question, where do you live? So by this, I want to know about the place. We go to temple every day. So we can put the question, where do you go every day? Where do you go every day? Right? Next, when we asking about time of something. So whenever we want to know about the time of something, so WH word, when we should use, like, I attend my online classes at 9:30. I attend my online classes at 9:30. So 9:30 is time. So whenever we want to know about time, so we should use when. When do you attend your online classes? Right? So by this, I want to know about the time. Second, I will meet you tomorrow. I will meet you tomorrow. So tomorrow is time. So if I want to know about the time, so I will say, when will you meet me? When will you meet me? Which for asking about options. So whenever we have the options and we want to know about the options, so we should use which. So if I say that I have two pens, means two options we have. So if I want to know about the option, which option would you like to take? So we need to use which. Which pen would you like to take? Right? You have bought three t-shirts. You have bought three t-shirts. So three options we have. So whenever we want to know about the one option, So we should use which word? Which one do you like the most? Which one do you like the most? How? For asking about manner. So whenever you want to know about the manner, we should use how word. Like how, sorry, he works slowly. So his style of working is very slowly. So whenever we want to know about the manner means tarika. So we should use how word like how does he work? Wo kaise kaam karta hai? How does he work? He works slowly, right? This exercise we will do tomorrow, right? So it's enough for today. Only 2 minutes are left. So dear students, if you want to ask any question, then please come forward. Otherwise, I am going to end the class.